About a month and a half ago, I announced that we've been building a casino course, and since that time, coming up on 200 people have picked it up. And looking at the Facebook group, it's people from everywhere. I'm completely overwhelmed, and I just have to say thank you. If you watch the channel regularly, you can probably imagine it's a pretty detailed course. There's a section on music, how to warm up, obviously all of the fundamental turns with details for leading and following. And the whole idea of the course is to give you simple turn sequences that you can use for social dancing. The way that those are gonna look the best is if you incorporate styling, which there's a section on that, of course, and body movement. And that is one of the sections that I've gotten the best feedback about. So happy Friday, I'm gonna put the entire body movement portion of the course here on YouTube. And if you find that you enjoy it, speaking of Friday, with promo code Friday at checkout, the entire course is just $49. I broke everything down into chapters. These are all things that I wish I focused on a lot earlier in my dancing. It starts off with isolations, gets into finding your posture and your frame, goes over weight transfer, basic coordination, and then applying the mechanics of this body movement into your basic step. And thanks to Miss Clara Nieto, there is a section just for ladies. I'm happy to share everything here, whether people pick up the course or not, but where it's a long form how-to type of video, it's probably gonna get buried in the algorithm. So if you could help it out with giving the video a like, perhaps leaving a nice comment, it would be very much appreciated. And without further ado, this is the body movement section of the Casino Level 1 digital course. All right, so let's isolate a few parts of our body. Let's start with the arms outstretched to the side. And the idea here is I want to get some torso isolation from one side back to the other. The arms are going to be out just as a guide, because when I move the torso, I want them parallel to the ground. I don't want them to dip one way or the other. So if you think of it like you got a table that you want to keep level, if you think of it like an airplane, whatever works for you, if I just reach out to my left, I want to make sure that the arms stay parallel to the ground, come back to neutral, reach out to the right, arms parallel, come back to neutral. And the other thing is I want to make sure my hips aren't moving, so I'm not just putting all my body to one side or the other. I want to keep the hips pretty much in the same position that they're in and just isolate this torso. So arms are outstretched, I'm going to go to my left, bring it back to the middle. Go to my right, back to the middle. Left, middle, right, middle. And then I can throw the entire range of motion. Left, right, left, right, left, right. So you want to be very conscious about the arms. So as you get more comfortable, you can test kind of bringing them down side to side, and then retest, bring them up, and see if you're able to keep the arms level. The next thing we're gonna do is the forward direction. So I've got my arms in front of me, and I'm going to reach with the left side, come back to neutral. Reach to the right side, come back to neutral. Left, neutral, right, neutral. And I'm not gonna think about trying to grab something with the hands. I still want the movement to come from the trunk of my body. These are just a guide. And then I can go left, right, left, right, without taking a break in the middle.
Let's start with your shoulders. Okay, what we want is to start with the right shoulder. We wanna send your shoulder forward, then up, back, down. Imagine you have 4 points you want to touch. We touch forward, we touch up, we touch back, we touch down, forward, up, back, down, forward, up, back, down. Same thing with the other one. We want to go forward, up, back, down, forward, up, back, down. So there is a difference between up and back. It's kind of rolling it back and find that shoulder line position. So when you're up, you're up. It's like really, really up next to your neck. Like try to space your shoulder with your ear. And then back is more like with your shoulder line. And then down is pushing it down. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. What we want after touching just the points with separate shoulders, we want to do it with both. One, then we go up, we go back, squeeze your shoulder blades, and then we go down, really down. Forward, up, back, down, forward, up, back, down, forward, up, back, down. What we want after is to rotate the shoulders, touching every point we reached with a sharp movement. Rotating, putting all those points together. And then we want to do it with the other shoulder too. And then both together. And then one first, and then the other one. One first, and then the other one. One first, and then the other. You can do it with your arm relaxed, with your frame set. And then try this with different speeds, with a very slow zone, with a medium zone, with a faster zone. Okay, and then you can apply this movement to your basic coordination. Right, let's talk about the hips and some exercises that will help you to like set free a lot of these muscles. I want you to bend your knees and try to really push to the sides, right, left, right, left. When you push, try to expand here and contract this muscle. So that's what we want. Same thing when we touch the point we have forward and the point we have backward, we wanna contract your abs without creating like a C here. We don't want that. We wanna keep our frame. We wanna push, like setting your pelvis up, and then push back, search to the sky with your butt, like push back without engaging your upper back. We wanna set the frame and just use your lower back and contract, push from there. We wanna go neutral, forward, center, back, neutral, forward, center, back. What we want is to now draw the full line. We wanna go forward to back, forward and back, forward and back. And now we wanna mix this. Let's go to the sides, 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 sides. We go forward, back, forward, back. Let's go with a circle. We go forward, right, back, left. Forward, right, back, left. We want to draw now a full circle. Forward, right, back, left. Forward, right, back, left. And then change the sense. Forward, left, back, right. Forward, left, back, right. We need to try this with different speeds. So let's go with the medium one. The accent will be behind. So instead of saying forward, left, back, right, so we will say one, 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 one. We go faster. One, 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 one. We wanna hit backward the heartbeat. I never straighten my legs. I always bend my knees and keep it there. So this will be my frame for my hip movement. Let's go to the other side. We go slow, 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 slow. We go fast. One, 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 and one.
If I wanna find a good starting posture, I'm gonna start with a good standing posture. So some people, when they're standing, they can be kind of slumped, so the pelvis is tucked forward, their shoulders are hunched over, or you might be somebody who has kind of an exaggerated curve in their back, probably gonna cause your chest to be poked out. We don't want that either. So I'm gonna start with my hips. I don't want them tucked too much, or I don't want this exaggerated curve. I just wanna have them neutral, and I can kind of lock that in with a little bend in the knees. And then for the torso, I don't want an exaggerated forward, and I don't want to lose my posture and slump my shoulders. Just neutral is good. From there, I'm going to roll the shoulders back and down and keep them engaged. And so that's going to help engage these muscles here. And when we start moving arms, all the arm movement is going to start from that area. So I start with a good posture, little bend in the knee, Roll my shoulders back and down, hold them there. And then I'm gonna reach up without letting the shoulders go up to my ears. I'm gonna keep them engaged down and then bring the arms down to sort of a tabletop height, 90 degree-ish bend in the elbow. And that's a good place to start from. So, good posture, bend in the knees, roll the shoulders back and down, reach up, bring the arms down. And then from there, all I'm gonna do is find the balls of my feet and put the weight there. So I've got my starting position here, and so if my weight is sort of just evenly dispersed on my feet, I just wanna have a little bit of a favor towards the balls of my feet so that your cats can knock over everything. And then to balance that out, I'm just gonna have my hips back a little bit. So good posture, bend in the knees, roll the shoulders back and down, arms up, bring them down. I'm gonna find the balls of my feet, and then I'm gonna balance the weight by bringing my hips back. And then from there, this is where I'm gonna start doing my steps. So we're giving all this attention to body movement to get a particular aesthetic, and that can all fall apart real fast if we have improper weight transfer. So I wanna show some drills that you can do to get a feel for where the weight should be when you step. But I also wanna show the perils of improper weight transfer. So the whole idea is that we've got a grounded connection and we're using that energy from the ground to kind of create a wave of energy up our body that we can harness to accentuate different parts of the body, exaggerate certain movements, have our cats knock a bunch of shit over. Thanks. And overall manipulate our body's natural movements that it uses to balance itself to create a particular aesthetic. So if we have improper weight transfer, we can't do that, but even worse than that, we can look like we're dancing bad merengue. So if you saw somebody doing body movement that's typical of popular dance, you'd see that there's some bent knees happening, you'd see some hips might be getting exaggerated, you'd see some torso movement, opposite arm, opposite foot. But the problem is, you can put the weight in the wrong spot real easy. So when I'm transferring the weight from one side to the other, it's following where the knee is bent. So if there was a scale that was underneath the bent leg, it would read more than if it was underneath the straight leg. And what can happen is people neglect that and they have the bent leg weightless and they'll still have a hip exaggerated, they'll still have the torso going, they'll still have opposite arms, but now we're doing something that looks like that and it's very easy to do and we don't want to do that. So the first thing we can do is find a wall and put your hands on the wall, give yourself a little bit of an angle and just gonna push against the wall. So if I pretend that I'm pushing a car, I'm using the bent leg to push. And I want that same sensation when I'm standing more upright, but it can be a little bit tricky to get that. So we're gonna use, hello. So we're gonna use this drill here to get a feel for it. We can also do a modified version. Some might call it a shopping cart if you get a chair. But if you do these drills and you push like you've pushed anything in your life before, it'll help you know where to put the weight when we step. Are you happy? So I've got my good standing posture. I get a bend in the knee. I roll the shoulders back and down, arms up, down into frame. All right, I'm just gonna leave them bent with a 90 degree elbow. I'm gonna find the weight on the balls of my feet, balance with my hips a little bit. Sir. And then I'm gonna bring the weight towards my left side and then to my right side. Left, right. Left, right. Left, right. Left, right. Let the arms hang a little bit and see what's happening with the torso and the shoulder. It's nice and relaxed. I'm gonna pick up the arms, make sure that everything is staying nice and level when I'm going side to side. Put the arms in front. Get a little bit of forward and back going in the shoulders. And then I'm gonna bring them down. And I'm gonna start harnessing this torso movement to drive the arms. So I'm not thinking about my hands or my arms being separate. It's gonna look disconnected and disjointed. I'm gonna use the torso movement side to side and forward and back to allow my hands to draw circles as they balance. So good posture, bend in the knee, roll the shoulders back and down, reach down, bend in the elbow, arms are tabletop. And then from there, I'm just gonna shift my weight. I'm gonna find the balls of my feet, Hips can be back a little bit to balance, and I'm just gonna move the weight side to side, side, side. So I'm not applying a cadence yet. No 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. I'm just tuning into connecting with the ground, and I'm using the energy from the ground to drive any motion that's happening. It's all dependent on the motion that comes before it. So we start with the floor, we're going up to the knee, and then to the hips, and how we kind of manipulate this energy is gonna determine if we have kind of a masculine or a feminine aesthetic. So if I wanted to put more hips, if I'm dancing the girl's part or whatever, I'm gonna use that energy, and I'm just gonna exaggerate the natural movement. But I'm not really doing anything out of the ordinary for my body. That would be any different than walking or jogging. The men, not so much, gonna exaggerate the hips, but we're gonna continue up the chain. And so we've got the torso. If I wanna have a little bit of a more exaggerated torso movement, I'm just turning up the dial on the natural movement that's already there. But everything is dependent on what comes before it. So the torso is gonna be what's driving the arms. So if I want these kind of like small arm circles here, wax on, wax off, if you're old enough to know that reference. But for example, if I find that I want more amplitude in the arms, I'm not just gonna move the arms bigger because it's gonna look completely disconnected. It's gonna lose that flow from the ground up. So what I'm gonna do is make sure that my torso movement is enough to drive the arms bigger, and then exaggerate a little bit of the natural movement of the arms to get these bigger arm circles. So we're gonna take this foundation of movement that we've been doing and apply it to the steps for men and ladies. So once the weight transfer and the coordination start to feel a little bit more natural, we can apply the cadence of the dance and start moving our bodies around a little bit. So, broken record, but we've got a good posture. Bend in the knee. Roll the shoulders back and down, reach up, bring them down. We got 90 degree, relaxed arms. All right, we're gonna find the weight on the ball of our foot. Hips can be back to balance, all right? And we're just gonna bring the weight side to side, to side, to side, side, side. I can make sure my torso is moving with some amplitude to give my arms a little bit of juice here. And so then I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. And so from there, I'm just gonna take the left foot, put it underneath myself, and step together, together, and then out. Together, together, 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 out. From the front, good posture. Bend in the knee, roll the shoulders back and down. Up, down, relax, 90 degree bend. And then we're just going to move side to side, to side, to side, to side, to side. If we do mirror image, we're gonna start with the left foot. Left, right, left. Right, left, right. Left, right, left. Right, left, right. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Paso son, here we go. 5, 6, 7, and together, together, out. Together, together, out. Together, together, out. Together, together, out. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, everything you have learned until now is applicable for both follower and leader, but we will add a few details for my ladies here. This exercise is to also improve the movement of the 8 shape that we wanna have when we do our basic. Let's bend a little bit the knees. We wanna push to the side and then push back. We have a new diagonal forward to reach to our left. We push and then we send the hip back. And then we reach forward and then we send the hip back. Same thing to the other side and push back. 1, 3, 5, 7. 1, 3, 5. Let's add the cadence. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. Okay, let's start with the frame. The position and the body alignment, it's a little bit on the ball of your feet. We don't want to sink on the heel. We will be late. We won't be ready to execute our own movements and to receive the energy from our partner. So what you want to do is to rock a little bit forward and back until you find that balance that when you are on the ball of your feet, not like ballerina style, but make sure you are in the ball of your feet. Relax your knees. I won't say noodle or sink. Just relax. You can control better the weight transfer, right? So now we have the way the body alignment set a little bit pitching forward. We want to raise your arms to your sides of your body here. Nothing about the perhaps position. No, put your shoulders down and then think about putting your shoulder blades together, like you could squeeze a lemon between them. And then from there, pushing back and down, put down your arms. And then search for your chest position. So we will start from here. So what I would like to add for the coordination of your torso movement will be like, think about you have a piece of paper, a blank piece of paper on your chest, and you have two Sharpies on your hands, and you want to draw two circles on it, like this. One arm first and then the other one. After this, you want to include the cadence of the dance. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. If we add this to the coordination you just learned and engage the muscles that you have on your rib cage, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Try to send some energy to your elbows. 6, 7. Make sure your arms are not the one that lead the movement, but your torso is. Your core is. 7, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. Now let's go with the hips. As I said, if we have the knees relaxed and the weight is in the ball of my feet, it's easier to have a wide angle, a wide space here to move my hips freely, effortlessly. So what I want you to try is to set the frame and alignment for your body and try to push to the sides your hips, but also thinking about contracting the muscles on your rib cage. Not only push the hip, but also contract here. I would say this is part of your abs, right?
Yeah, the obliques.
Okay. Yeah, the obliques, right. Try to contract your obliques to make it even bigger. And do not stretch your legs. Keep it bended. So I will start like discovering the movement of my hips like that. Once you reach the farthest point with your hip, you want to start pushing back and then change diagonal forward to the other side. We push back and then change diagonal forward. We push back and change diagonal forward. We want to draw like an 8 movement with the hips. I just wanted to like really exaggerate these movements once you're practiced, so you can develop a muscular memory. That's it, we push, 8, 8, 8 movement, 8 movement. Okay, let's apply this movement of the hips with the coordination and the timing of the steps. As you learn, when we change the weight of our body from one side to the other one, keeping the knees bended, the hips will be in the opposite side of the foot that you will change the weight to. So if I'm changing to my left, my hip is here, ready to change to the other side. Hip and change, hip and change, change, change. So we will refill the upbeats. 1, 2, 3, And. So what I mean is that I don't want sharp movements, but refilling all the counting from one side to the other one. If we apply this into our base, it will look like 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. I will count now the upbeats. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. One detail more. When we're doing Paso de Son, let's make sure we are stepping below our body, not beyond, because it doesn't matter how long you wanna do your step. What matters is how short you wanna do your step under your body so you have a wide angle to move your hips. If I do this, my hip won't move as much as if I move it here, right? So you wanna step from your belly button, keeping your steps under your body, traveling with your weight. So I will go with the Paso de Son. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. Baby step, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1. Okay, let's apply everything in our basic steps. We'll do forward and back and Paso de Son. Let's do the body alignment first. Let's check that everything is okay. Let's rock a little bit forward. Weight of your body on the ball of your feet. Relax your knees. Notice how you can just change the weight of your body easy. And set the frame for your arms, shoulders, core. And here we are, ready. Okay, let's put everything together. 1, 3, 5, 7. Basic 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3. Let's go back to the center. 1, 2, 3. Paso de Son. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7.
So if you made it all the way through, those drills and principles are a good thing to incorporate into your warm-up if you just do a little bit every day. The movement is gonna feel a lot more natural quicker than you think. If you'd like to see what the rest of the course has to offer at what, in my opinion, is, quite frankly, not to use Friday language, but a heck of a discount, you can go ahead and follow the link in the pinned comment and description and wherever links are. The promo code, it just so happens, is Friday.